Hi, my name is Brett Schneider. I'm the telestroke coordinator at UVA Health.
And I'm Abby Rieman, clinical program manager for the Stroke Center at UVA Health. May is Stroke Awareness Month, so we want to take a few minutes to tell you about stroke care at UVA.
We also want to describe the signs and symptoms of stroke. If you can recognize a stroke and take action, you might save a life someday.
UVA is proud to be a Joint Commission Comprehensive Stroke Center. This is the highest level of certification for stroke care that is available, and only 3% of hospitals nationwide achieve this certification.
Our world-class stroke care is not confined to our own hospital. Through our use of telehealth technology, we can remotely examine stroke patients at outside facilities and provide those physicians and staff with a decision on acute treatment options and an expert-directed short-term management plan.
Did you know that stroke is the fifth leading cause of death in the United States? A stroke is caused by an interruption of blood flow to any part of the brain, either due to a clot or bleeding within the brain. Stroke can have a devastating impact on an individual and their family. We're committed to reducing the impact of stroke on our community. But to do so, it's important that everyone knows what a stroke looks like and what to do if they suspect someone is having a stroke.
There's an acronym that we teach that can help anyone remember the signs and symptoms of stroke. This acronym is BFAST. Any sudden onset of any of the following symptoms could mean that someone is having a stroke and that it's time to take action.
B stands for balance. This can include any new difficulty maintaining balance, getting out of bed or up from a chair, or trouble walking.
E stands for eyes. Check if the patient is having difficulty seeing out of one or both eyes, has blurred vision, or can't see what's happening towards one side of their body.
F is for face. Ask the person to make a big smile and show their teeth. Does one side droop or not move in the same manner as the other? Look for any asymmetry in the face.
A is for arms. Ask the patient to raise their arms out in front of them. Check to see if they have difficulty moving one arm or another, or perhaps they can't keep both arms raised and one arm drifts down.
S is for speech. Ask them to repeat a simple phrase like, "It's always sunny in Charlottesville." If the speech is slurred or they can't speak at all, then it's time to take action.
The last letter is an important one. T stands for time. Time to call 911 without delay. The best option for making sure the individual receives the best possible care is to call 911 and have them evaluated and transported by the emergency medical services, even if the symptoms seem mild. It's important not to wait, as some treatment options can only be provided within a specific time frame.
So if you suspect a stroke, just remember to be fast and you could help save a life. Thanks for watching. If you have any further questions, please visit us on the web at www.uvahealth.com/stroke.